So hi guys, welcome or welcome back to the channel. So Maharashtra CET 5-year law entrance exam forms for 2021 are out. In this video, we're going to discuss everything like that of important dates, marks distribution. I'm going to tell you the important things, important instructions that you need to keep in mind before you fill the form and everything else. Chaliye, let's get into this video.
Yeah guys, welcome to Loggery. I hope you're subscribed to Loggery's YouTube channel and hit that bell notification so that you do not miss any of our videos. And I hope you're following us on Instagram. We're there by the name at I am Loggery. We do pretty motivational stuff out there. If you want to stay happy, if you want to stay motivated, and if you want to stay connected a little more with Loggery, then do follow us on Instagram.
Let's check the important dates. The registration began on 28 June 2021 and the last date of registration is 12 July 2021. So guys, 12 July is the last date of registration, and can you see the gap between the first date and the last date is so less. This means that though the date is to be announced later on, but we can guess that towards the end of July or in the beginning of August, we can expect that the exam might take place. So you need to be prepared. You need to make sure that you give yourself the date that, okay, in the end of July, I have my exam, and prepare accordingly, right? If you want to know how you need to prepare and everything else, I've already done a video. I'll leave the link in the description box below. Let's check out the eligibility criteria. Minimum of 45% marks in aggregate for open economically weaker section EWS category candidates and outside Maharashtra state candidates, that is all India candidates, right? So yeah, if you belong to open category from Maharashtra itself, if you are from all India category, or you are from EWS, then 45% marks are required. If you belong to SC ST category from the state of Maharashtra, then 40%. If you belong to SBC, OBC or VJNT belonging to state of Maharashtra, then 42%. Right, so this is the minimum eligibility criteria. The applicants who have obtained 12th plus 2 higher secondary pass certificate or first degree certificate after processing studies in distance or correspondent method is eligible for admission to this course. Right, age limit. At present, there is no upper age limit for admission to LLB 5 years integrated CET examination for the academic year 2021-2022. However, in view of the so-and-so judgment, so a case is pending wherein it is to be decided that should there be any upper age limit in 5-year law courses or not. So as of now, no age limit is there. Anyone can give the exam. There's a lot of confusion with regard to that, who can give the exam. Look, there is no age limit. So if you have passed your 12th, you can give the exam. Also, a lot of you have this question that I have just entered 12th in 2021. I have my exams in 2022. Can I give Maharashtra CET? Am I eligible? No, you're not eligible. You will be eligible in 2022, right? So if those candidates are eligible who had their board exams in 2021 or who have their board exams in 2021, they are eligible to give the exam, or who have given the board exams, 12 board exams in their past, and they have their certificate and everything, they can also, right? You can take unlimited attempts of this exam. There is no limit. So yeah, keep this in mind. Mode of the exam. So it is going to be online mode in multiple sessions if required in selected centers in state of Maharashtra and selected centers from other states. About the exam, very important, as I always say, please pay attention. The questions will be objective multiple choice questions with 4 options. So MCQ type of questions, no negative marking. Can you see? This is very, very important. There is no negative marking, which means if you attempt a question wrong, no marks are going to get deducted like in other exams, right? The time allotted is 2 hours, 1 hour and 20 minutes, which is a lot. The questions are going to be in English and Marathi. The mock test link for practice will be provided for the candidates to prepare themselves for online CET. Now, a lot of you ask me that please provide previous year question papers of Maharashtra CET. They are not available. So they provide you with mock tests. So do solve the mock test and see that how much you are prepared or which topics are there that you have not prepared and you should prepare. Okay, marks distribution, legal aptitude and legal reasoning 40 marks, general knowledge with current affairs 30 questions are going to be there, logical and analytical reasoning 40 marks, English 30, mathematical aptitude 10, total 150, 1 mark per question. Okay, examination fees, let's check out the examination fee. CET fee for open category, EWS category from Maharashtra state, outside Maharashtra state, all India candidates belonging to all categories, the fees is rupees 800, right? For all of these categories, the fees is rupees 600. Okay, let's read some important instructions. You need to read the information brochure really carefully. I have provided the link in the description box, so do check it out. Check the eligibility criteria mentioned in the information brochure. Scan their photograph and signature. So you need to have scanned photograph and signature. You need to have your email ID and mobile number that you're using, because you might get information, you might get mails related to the exam. So it should be in working condition. So the payment is going to take place online, so you need to arrange for this same. Photograph details, one of the things that you need to keep in mind is size of the photograph should be between 20 kb to 550 kb. It should be a recent passport size colored photograph. You can pause the video and check other details. A signature size of file should be between 10 kb to 20 kb. The applicant has to sign on white paper with black ink pen. Okay, On the day, you are advised to bring with you hall ticket with a fixed photo and valid photo ID card. You need to carry any valid photo ID card. It can be Aadhaar card, voter ID, passport, anything, right? In original, you need to carry the photo ID. Original proof for change in name, if any. If your name has been changed, then that proof you need to carry. One ballpoint pen, right? Carry 2 to 3 ballpoint pens, because you never know. Register. So you will see this interface when you click on the link that I have provided. New registration, you have to click on new registration and thereafter fill in your details, right? Now you guys might ask me that how should you prepare. So I've already done a video wherein I've discussed the entire syllabus. I've talked about the books from wherein you should study, how you should study, what is important and what is not. Do watch that video. The link is going to be in the description box below. I want to give you a disclaimer. Whenever it comes to any dates of any exam, you know, there are so many things that happen online. People tell, okay, this can be the date, that can be the date, and you go crazy. Always believe in the official website only. Don't believe in any other website or channel, just the official website. I think one tip that I want to give you is that think that you have just 15 days. Obviously, herein we know that till 12 July, the exam is not going to take place. And if we add one more week or at least 2 more weeks to it, we have that much of time. Give that date to yourself so that you should not be lazy. You should be studying, because you see, I told you, look, the gap between the first date when the application forms are open for you guys and the closing date, the gap is so less. It indicates that the exam is going to take place soon. Do not be afraid that when the exam is going to take place, you should be prepared. Start studying if you have not. And please do not believe in anything written on any website. Official website is the right source. Remember that, right? So no one has any links. If anyone says, oh, I have asked from internal sources, no, there's nothing like that. You just have to believe the official website, of which the link is going to be in the description box. Do not be afraid. Start studying. You can crack this exam. It is on the easier side, and if you crack this exam, you might get admission in GLC Mumbai, which is a really good college. There are other great colleges that come under this exam. So guys, that's it for today's video. I hope this video is helpful. If it is, please hit that like button, share this video, subscribe to the channel, comment down below that how can I help you more. And yeah, that's it. Logiri signing off. I'll see you super soon. Bye, take care, keep on studying.